Well, I've had some stuff show up in the mail, so let's do a mailbag. I don't know how interested you are in what I'm getting in the mail, but, oh, something from Germany. That's unexpected. I thought everything I was ordering was from China. Ah. Okay. These, more of these guys. What are they called? Wago terminals is what I've seen them called. Okay. That's cool. Those are real useful. Oh, and it actually says what they really are. Terminal. So, package of five. I got two packages of five for $1.61 Canadian per package, which is a good deal. Number two. Electronic components. No commercial value. Uh-huh. That's nice and generic. Okay, nothing there. Where'd that one come from? Hong Kong. Alright, so what do we got here? Where are you? Oh! That's a Bluetooth module, I believe. Gonna have to look that up in a minute. These Bluetooth module, which looks like this is the one that I got there, was a whole $2.91 from King Electronics. That's cool. What else have we got here? Test tubes of some sort by the looks of it. Oh. Yeah, okay, here we go. For getting in there and measuring across a small component or... Here we go. They're small components. I'm going to zoom in. That's very jerky. Anyways, and focus, yeah. So for taking my meter and measuring across itty bitty components like that guy and still having a hand free. How small can I go? Oh, there we go. That's going to come in useful rather than trying to fumble away with a couple of leads, two leads from different meters, whatever. Rather than trying to fumble away with two hands like that, and the board skating all over the place, and then not having a third hand to hold it in place or do something with. I like that. The test probe tweezers. $3.21 Canadian. That's excellent. That's going to help me a whole bunch, not swearing at my shaky hands and poor ancient eyesight. What do we got here? Maximum voltage 250 volts. I'm thinking I'm never going to be testing anything surface mount that's that high a voltage. Anyway, yeah, that looks like it's going to be a good one. What I got in this guy here? This is DC to DC. Value $10. That's unlikely. I don't spend that much. DC to DC. Okay, times four of them. What are you? Okay. Another DC to DC converter, obviously. I don't know whether it's a boost or a buck, but... And that's absolutely not helpful. I'm going to have to do some research online, I guess. Let's delve into this mystery voltage converter a little bit. I couldn't find it in my eBay history or my Banggood or my AliExpress history. So, we'll just experiment. I've got my power supply over here set for 3.5 volts. Actually, that works pretty well as a filter. Set to the input. So we'll turn him on and see what we get. Come on, Dremel, work with me. Okay, so that's on. The pot is just set to whatever the defaults were. It's at 3.4 out. Okay. That does nothing in that direction. What's this direction do? Nothing. Okay, let's crank this baby up then. Five-ish. Okay. Oh. Okay. So it's a boost converter. Max is out at 27. Okay. So now I'm going to start stepping this guy down. Can you see that? Yeah. 4.3, 3.9, 3.4. Oh, I guess I just didn't twist it enough. Oh, let's see. So turn him off. Turn him back on. Yeah, 3.4 volts, 2.9 volts. Oh, that's cute. Okay, let's just try a little something here. Actually, yeah. Here we go. Let's try Nokia lithium ion. It should be charged or very close to it. Light over that way. That ought to work, shouldn't it? There we go. 27 volts output. That's good. I want to try with AA, which, yeah, it's pretty good shape. But I'm going to have to delay for a second here. I'll just pause and find a battery box or something for a AA. Be right back. Okay, I'm back. So, just got a couple little ball magnets here and some clip leads. Not sure where I picked that trick up. Somebody on YouTube. Because that's where everybody learns everything these days. And that one's putting out 2-3 volts. So it can't quite handle, 1 volt. So it doesn't do a very good job down to 1.5 volts input. But it's fine off of lithium. That's cool. Okay, so it's a boost converter. In the time between shooting that video, this video, and editing it, another package showed up. So I might as well tack it on. This one came from Germany, which again is really bizarre because shipping from Europe to Canada is never free, and I only ever buy stuff with free shipping. This claims to be a strip. I am intrigued. Oh, I know. I know what these guys are. You guessed it yet? There's a clue. LED strips. Haha. These are 12 volt, 4 LEDs per segment. Okie dokie. Oh, and the ends are even conveniently pre-stripped. So, I think I mentioned earlier that I really like these Wago connectors. They're good for anything between 2080 WG and 1280 WG, which is a ridiculous range. I can't think of another connector that lets you connect that range together. So let's give our 12 volts. Oops. Let's give our 12 volts and see what happens here. 10, 11.99. Close enough. Okay. What? Nothing happens. Why does nothing happen? Let's maybe shut that off while I'm doing this. Maybe that's why nothing happened, because it was a fairly short stripped piece. And yeah, so no dicking around with screwdrivers or crimp terminals or anything else. Aha! That's more better. Oh, those are, I don't know, are they new? They're not cool, I don't think. I think those might actually be natural white. Let's go to the listing. Actually, before we go to the listing, what did I have that set for? 11.98 volts, current limited to 1 amp. It's drawing 750 milliamps, and it's still in constant current mode. That's bright. Okay, now then, back to the listing for sure this time. And here it is. Turns out I got these from Banggood, and I got them on sale for $2.28 per 5 meter, which is why I bought three of them, obviously. That's stupidly cheap. And yeah, free shipping to Canada. Wow, and they shipped it from Germany. That's just craziness. Cool. So my plan for these LED strips, when I ordered them anyway, well, partially the reason I ordered them is they're so cheap, how could I not? But my plan for them is to upgrade from the mongrel of lighting that I have on my workbench here, which you're going to love. I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to do this or not. But over here on stage left, we have the homemade ring light, which didn't really work very well, and it's too diffuse. Back there, we have two, I think there's 17 or 12 watt just standard LED bulbs acting as backlights. over here on stage right, we have my magnifier on an arm with another one of those same bulbs in it. Those are all in warm white. That one I think is in cool white or neutral white maybe. And then up here is a candelabra lamp that I mistakenly ordered, which was too big for what I planned on using it for, and it is in a really harsh cool white. And then over my shoulder is this fixture up there, which is 3 2-for-1 Y things with 300 watt equivalent LEDs and 160 watt equivalent LED, which are also the general room light. So my plan is to take these, well, some of these anyway, 15 meters of LEDs, and build them into the structure underneath the railroad, which is just above my workbench, and probably some on the sides to cut down on shadows, and make myself a single color temperature light source. Hopefully it works. I'm sure that will be a video in the future.